Morning, guys. I got something else I'm going to show y'all we do here. I haven't showed you these before, but I'll try to give you, I ain't going to teach you how to do it, but I'm going to give you kind of step view of how it's done. So, like I said, this is not an instructional video, so expect me to blow through it because I'm not training. So, anyway. We'll be making these double esterline ropes here. They use these on digger derricks. These will be 1-inch by 100-foot ropes with standardized each end. So we'll get into that a little later on. Show you the process of it.
A lot of people think that splice is easy. It is easy if you know how to do it, but it might take about 30 minutes to do a rope, you know, so. At least I used to could do it in 30 minutes. Now, I ain't done this about 2 years, so I'll fumble through it. But I've been doing these since I was about 16 years old. So, I passed the torch along to somebody else now. But I'm out here doing it because we ain't got no help. So I got to do it, right? Anyway, stay tuned.
Hey, guys, we're getting ready to mark this thing here. Old Steven over there is just pounding away on that sewing machine, ain't he? Yeah. You listen to him. We're going to mark this thing. Like I said, this ain't an instructional video. This is just, people just like to see how things are made. Mark that one full feed. Form my desired eye size, which that probably ain't in the camera. And let's see here. We're going to mark it about right there. Like I said, I ain't done these in a couple of years, so I'm a little green on it. But like anything else, once you start doing it, it come back to you. They're real easy to do. Need a better marker than this one. This one ain't marking very good, but it'll get me through. Chair sits too low for me too. I'm sitting on the floor.
I don't see how Gary.
I don't either. But it is what it is. Well, now we got them marks made. Now I'm gonna count back 8 sets of strands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right here. Go all the way across. If you try to do these exactly how the instruction book goes, you'll be just really confused. I asked Yale Cordage one time. I already knew how to splice it. In fact, I had been splicing longer than the instructor at one time. And went up there in the class, and I was done before everybody in the class. He goes, "Man, you seem like you've done this before." I said, "Well," I said, "how long you been doing it?" And I don't remember what he said. But I'd been doing it longer, and I said, "Why don't they write the book by just going ahead and marking everything on the cover?" He said, "Well, you do it exactly how I do it, but they didn't know how to put that in the book where people can understand it." And I said, "Well, it really don't make sense the way it's written in the book either." He said, "I agree." Well, anyway, I always draw a little line here. I don't know, it just helps me when I do it. Book don't say do that, but when I'm pulling it in, if I see that line, I know I did something wrong. It's just a habit I got, I guess. And I have done it wrong. Now we're gonna count these strands back. It'd be a 4, 4, 5, 4, 4, 5. So there's 2 strands to a pair. So it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so I'm not gonna bore you with all that. I'll get them marked and come back. bam, I'm back. So what I did here is had to mark for the taper. You got to taper the cover to go down the center of the cord. What I did is I marked it 445, 445, 445, all the way down through there. And different counts of rope, you do different numbers. It could be 454 or whatever. So you gotta know which count you have on your rope, and I'm not gonna get into all that. But anyway, that's the first part of it. Now, what I did here is I come down here and went 3/4 of a fid down. Oh, by the way, this is a fid, a tubular fid. Certain diameter, certain lengths for certain size rope. But what I marked this for, this is where the core will come out the cover. And they say go a short fid. And a short fid is, there's two lines right here. This is a short fid, and this all the way is a long fid. Then naturally a half fid. They say go a short fid down here to put this mark. I don't do that. I always go about 3/4 of a fid because in some cases I feel like more is better. And so I just like putting a little bit more tail down in there. Now we've got to extract the core out of the cover. What I like to do, is go on down there and complete this other step before I start this step, right? Okay, so what I meant to do before we started extracting the core is you want to see how I got these tied off in knots. These are pull points, and you don't want your slack of your cover to go beyond this point. So this just locks it in place, doesn't let it feed down to the other end of the rope, or the middle of it, however you want to call it, the way I got it set up. Well, anyway, we're getting back to this other step. So what I do is I kind of crunch it up a little bit like that, and you want to make sure you don't catch your cover. See, there's two strands there. You want to split them strands. And I just go in there and get a little bit of the cover out, or the core, I mean. And then dig at it a little bit more, like so. There we go. Yeah, see there? And you want to pull it, and as you can tell, that's bunching up right there, but you'll pull it, and you always want to keep your hand on it right there, and you want to feel when that end comes out. And right there it is now. What I'm going to do is, if I had tape, I'd show you what I was going to do. Can you get me some tape, Steven? Thank you, sire. I'm old fumble fingers today. I keep dropping everything. So what I'm going to do, you see there? And I just keep it in my hand and tightly tape that in. And I stretch it down pretty good because eventually that end right there is going to slip in there, and I'm going to tape it right there. Some people don't tape it. Some people use a pusher rod, which I use down there and just push it through. But I like to tape it on there because sometimes I have to pull it through if it's tight and I don't want it to come off. So anyway, that's what we do. Now we got to, I'll do all of them and I'll come back. All right, so we got all these ends taped up. Now what we're gonna do, we got to push them down. Then what we do, we milk the cover back up on the cord. And you don't want to do it too tight. You want to just, usually you got about that much difference. Sometimes it's about right there, but that's good. If you get too tight, it sometimes can be hard to pull up when you start doing your eye. Thank you. then what I want to do is mark where the core is at the edge of the cutter. That's where our first sets of marks start on the core. And we're gonna push these back again, get them out of the way. See that right there? Right there is where I marked it. That's where this was. It was right here where the core come out. Okay, now what we're gonna do, we're gonna mark this core. One short fid, which is right here, and then make a dot, be one full fid plus a short. That'll be right here. Now, I always cheat and I lay them up and I just mark them all same time like that. All right, now, where I tape this on to here. I'm doing that left-handed, so. Anyway, we got our crossover mark here. Now we got these two marks here. And that's where I'll be running the cover into the core. Make sure you don't split any strands. Just gonna run it through there. And then we're gonna come out right there. Make sure there ain't no twist in it and stuff. Just like that. Well, that's what we got. Now, you remember that part we made all them little dots through here? So, here's the boring part. You got to take each one of them, pull it up like that. I always start from this end because it draws it up, and you can do that right there, and it just pops it out of that tape. I got to do every one of these. And this is the part I hate doing. Actually, I don't like really doing none of it, but because I've done it for so long, but hey, pays the bills. If I could just get old Steven over there to learn how to do it, I wouldn't have to worry about it no more. Ain't that right?
Something like that.
But you don't want to take them all out. Because if it's too thin down here at the end where the tape is, when you'll see that process later on. You gotta have something to hang on to. You don't need to be tapered down that much. And plus, you don't wanna go too far ahead on pulling these out because then you won't know where to cut them off at. So you wanna, dude, them scissors are dull. You don't have to sharpen them things. So, you know, just lay these to the side. I got a box I throw them in, but.
Man. You want this other?
Is there another pair of these down there? Hey, technical difficulties.
There you go,
we'll give these a try and see if they're any better. But anyway, so pull these out. And usually if you pull these out and you pull one out that's already been cut, that means you marked it wrong, which it happens. But it doesn't hurt anything as long as you're smart about it and you say, well, we don't need to take that one out. We need to probably pull this one out. So all you're doing is tapering in so it'll look better. And you can get it down the core. So, all right, let's see if these cut any better. Oh, yeah. Okay. And we're gonna take a few more out here. All right, so that's kind of what you want. Mike. Might go a little thinner. That's quite a bit still there. Let's bring it down just a little bit more. I'm gonna take these out. This rope here is made by Aaron Rope. It's a USA company. Before all this, I used to do Yale cordage, which personally I think is the best in the US. I think it's better than Sampson. But they got a really good product, but you pay for it. And this Aaron Rope here, these people have done me a good job. They work well with us. I just don't like their core as much. They use four, where Yale's is a little bit more dense. It's easier to work with. But, I mean, that's the only complaint I got. It's just this is a lot looser, where theirs is a lot more dense. It's the only difference. So anyway, I won't bore you with the rest of this. I'll get this all done and come back to you. How about that, right? Hang in there. So I told you I like to start from this end. I was wrong, I forgot. Been a while, like I said. Actually, I like starting from this end. It makes it easier, and it's a lot more dense in here when you're cutting it out. And usually I usually don't cut out that last set right there. I think I usually come down to here, but anyway. Yeah, I told you wrong. Just wanted to correct that. All right, so we got them all to that point there. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to pull this back. Now, I like to put something in there. You don't want this to slip through the thing. Chuck's hot, he wants the heater off. I don't know why it's even on. I just forgot to turn it off. It is hot, ain't it?
Yeah, a tidbit.
I'm surprised you ain't got your hoodie on.
Well, you saw I take off my long sleeve shirt.
Anyway, so you're gonna pull it out to expose that mark here. Then, I'm gonna put that in there and we're gonna retape it. So sewing machines sound like a machine gun going off, don't it? Alright, now we're gonna put this in right here, try not to split any strands. Like so. And we're gonna go all the way down the center. We'll make sure you don't get your core here too. In fact, I pull on a little bit as I'm going through there just to make sure I didn't get it. It's easy to do. And we're gonna go down to that 3/4 fed mark right there, I have. Lost my place there for a minute. Here we go. Yep, so right there, I feel like I grabbed the core there a little bit. Here we go. All right, now we're gonna bring it out here to the side. Here, it don't matter if you split them or not, because it's gonna be pulled right back in there. All right. We're gonna pull it up tight there. And now, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this down even like that, and I'm just gonna take these two and I'm gonna pull it. And I'm gonna tighten that cross over just like that. Some people will put tape on it right there, but I've been doing it so long I don't have to. Watch me need to this time. So let's check it again. And I'm just gonna take this tape off. Just like this. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna hold the crossover right here, just keep it flipping. All right, we're gonna just pull it around like that. Then, we're gonna pull that. Then what we're gonna do, we're gonna pull it a little bit and we're gonna milk this section down like that. Usually you can mark it here, but I don't. We're gonna pull it out right there. And I'm gonna cut it about, I don't know, 3/4 of an inch shy of my thumb, something like that. Let me pull it out a little bit more, right there. I'm gonna cut it off. You want a little shorter because you want to pull back up into the cover. I always look at my tails. If I see a tail that's that short or if I see a tail that's long, I know I messed up somewhere, but it's just a good little extra check. Now what I want to do is I want to feather this out. And I usually a feather at about a short fed length, somewhere around in there. So there's the two marks there. So we're going to feather it out about like that. So I just do that. And I lay it hand like this and I just start cutting it at a taper. That. See there? And that won't make a bulge at the once it goes in there. Now, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna milk this right back up in there like that. See that? Now it's disappeared. Now we're gonna start milking this up. Just like that. And you'll make sure that stays right there and you just kind of work it around. All right, break time for them. You hear them cracking them cold ones?
It ain't break time.
What? I thought it was break time. I keep hearing these soda pops cracking. No wonder I'm out here having to get caught up. He ain't doing nothing but drinking sodas.
I gotta keep my investment going.
All right, so you want to keep it equal. You don't want no slack over here, so you gotta work it around. And then you go all the way back down here. And you want to milk this up tighter. You want it to the point where it starts burning your hand. You just keep going down there and you want to pull it up to that mark right there. There it is. Look at there. There's a finished product. Now what we'll do, we'll come in here and whip it right here with some stitching. We'll wrap it several times and lock it in. That way it doesn't have nothing to do with the strength, but what it does, it just keeps from somebody pulling it out. Like if it hangs on something or something. So anyway, I got a bunch more to go. And I hope you found that fascinating. It's a pretty neat little deal. A lot of people don't realize it ain't like a ski rope where it's hollow. This is a double braid polyester and core goes in the cover and the cover goes into the core. So it's a process, but it's easy once you learn it. So we'll get all these done. Steven, what are you doing over there?
I am making a cover, a sleeve cover for a round sling.
Oh yeah.
And it's gotta be sewn down the middle as well. And once I get that done, the person making the round sling can slide it on there and finish it up.
Yeah. So yeah, this ought to be that'd be an interesting one to watch too. We got to make these sleeves first, because we found that, because these things got to be sewed down the middle once they get on these big orange round slings. We tried sewing them on after the fact. So we've learned now to do one tube on one side and then sew it down the middle and leave the other side open, so we only have one side to sew, which makes it a lot better. Anyway, we'll show you that on the next one if I don't forget to film it. Out of here. Now, we're going to whip the eyes is what we're going to do. So we're going to show you this. Just double it back like that. And then we're going to just go round and round. Oop, messed that one up. Let's try that again. All right, fumble fingers, let's go. You old, but you ain't that old, boy. All right, here we go. I usually go about 14 wraps. I usually go about 5.5 fed lengths on my cord here.
I've
got to say right now, okay. Right now, David. Bob needs you in there with a customer. So we go about 14 wraps, and then we lock it. Every time I get in the middle of filming something, somebody needs me, you know. I'm just that important, I guess. I don't know why. It's either somebody needs a heater turned off, or a customer comes in, or Carl wants to ask me a bunch of questions. I'm just kidding. I do a lot around here, so more than I want to do. Anyway. Oh, yeah, I got confused. See there? And we'll stitch it up here in a little bit, and I'll show you the rest of it. All right. Got it whipped. Now we're going to sew it. This one, I go straight through, just like that. Pull it tight. And I always want to make sure my strands are laid sideways. So then we go in, center, and come out the side, like so. And then go in here and we go straight through. Yeah, need to get a little closer than that. Let's see here. There we go. Sometimes, I think I went through the strand there, makes it hang up. There we go. I just pulled my finger in between there. I want to pull it so it don't get crossed up. Then we're going to go there and we're going to go quarter through to this side. Like that. And then we're going to go all the way through again. Like that. Cut that off. Boy, them scissors are bad. And we're gonna cut them off a little short, like that. That off a little short. I'm gonna take that. I'm just gonna tighten old knot. That knot just helps it from slipping through. Do it a couple times. Like that. We're gonna cut it off. I like fuzzing the ends out a little bit because I'm going to melt the ends down. Now, usually just take this little old torch here. The chair sits too low for me. I like to be at least right here, but hey, you work with what you got. All right, so I bend it like that so I don't get into the rope itself. I just want to melt the strands. Turn, let it burn, and then just dab it down. Flip it over and do the other side. You don't want to get none of that on you because it will burn the heck out of you. There you go. That's all you do. Let me finish doing that to all the rest of them. Then I'll show you how we put the tags on. Now we're going to put the tag on. Watch this. Put this on this little label here. And we're gonna put that right here. Like so. I mean, we got a shrink tube that we had already put on this before we put the eyes in. We'll pull that up on there. Like so. Like that right there. I love doing this. Now we're gonna shrink it down. Yeah, And there you go. Let me show you the capacity on this thing.
You can see that okay. Right there is 8,400 pound vertical. Five times that's the braking strength. So how you like that? Nice looking, isn't it?
Anyway, that's all I got. Actually, I should have cut four of these and I only did three. Duh. Anyway, I'll show you that later.